big valuable points so far that we're seeing in these workshops, particularly for people in the corporate world, is the ability to bring some new problem solving skills to their teams, and also learn how to talk about design value in a different way. So whether they're designers or non-designers, they're being given the tools to see design in a different way, to see that design is more than just an aesthetic exercise, that it's actually a problem-solving process. So they are approaching problems that they might encounter in their work life that they might not have realized before, that they can bring designers in to help them solve those problems much earlier in the process. So for example, rather than bringing design in to just design the user interface for a product, they can actually bring designers in and help them create or identify the real problem to start with, and identify what the opportunity is before a brief is ever created for a problem. The first workshop really focuses on understanding how to identify problems and opportunities, and establishing the process and the language of design so that everybody is speaking that same language. Whether you're a designer, an executive, an entrepreneur, whether you're, have in-house design, or you're hiring a designer to do something for you, establishing that common language is really critical. The second module is understanding the consumer in even more detail, looking at consumer behavior, understanding trends also in both consumer and technical worlds. So digging really deep into more parameters and how to kind of evolve the brief and understand the problem more deeply is really the focus of the second module. And designers are critical in that role because they do understand consumer behaviors. They really can look at a problem more holistically than many other functions can. So they're really important people in that evolution of the brief and the evolution of a problem identification. On the product side, advancements in technology in terms of 3D modeling capabilities and the materials that we're using have for a couple of decades now enabled designers in product and architecture to push things beyond what was possible before, of course, to the point where it looks now like a lot of products and buildings were created by aliens and gods even. When you look at some smartphones and you look at some structures that almost defy gravity and where their forms are so complex that they don't look man-made at all. As with any trend, we see things pushed to their extreme before they are pulled back a little bit, and we see a leveling out of those trends. And the same thing is happening with technology right now in design, where I think we're at that peak of seeing a bit of more of a return to evidence of human touch in product and building and even interface. Designers have a really special role of being able to understand a consumer's needs, understand a market opportunity, understand business, because they are the ones that are helping to create the products that are making profit for a company. And they have the ability, the creative ability, to put all of those things together and find opportunities for innovation and new ways of thinking about problems. And through things like form and color and the tactility of materials and how somebody feels in a space or how somebody reacts to something that's on a screen, designers can really drive human behavior. You can make somebody feel really happy by being in a particular type of environment, or make them feel good about themselves by how they interact with a product. So it is a really special role, really important role, in that you can really drive that behavior and drive a person's well-being. So it's a critical role, and it's an important role. And a lot of people don't realize how much their involvement, a designer's involvement in the process, can help make something really successful.